Hey guys, welcome back to Auto Repair Guys. Thank you guys for watching and subscribing to the channel. Today will be super helpful video guys to any of you having a Hyundai or Kia with a 2.4 GDI engine and you need to remove or replace oil pumps. Stay with us, we'll explain how to do that, everything from start to finish. It's a long procedure, but you can do it guys. It's not as complicated as you think. Make sure to stay until the end. We'll share guys some common mistakes that can cost you thousands of dollars and what to avoid, because otherwise you might end up buying new balance shafts, which is super expensive as well. So all that will be covered guys in this video. Before we start, let me tell you a little bit about us. Every single car we get at the garage, we try to make at least 200 to 300 free repair videos. Why? Simply because our mission in the shop is to save you as much money as we can. All we need in return, please subscribe to the channel, like the video, that way we can keep making these videos absolutely free for you guys. Now if you need to buy any parts, tools, new oil pump, anything for a really good price and quick shipping, check out the link in the description of the video below. That's where we get all our tools and supplies from. Let's go ahead, start on it. It will take a little bit of work, but we will do all that to get to the oil pump now. So this is the 2.4 GDI engine. That's how it's going to be in your car. It has been used in more than 10 Hyundai and Kia models guys. That's one very very popular engine, by the way. So if you look at it now, okay, what do we need to do here? We need to grab the upper engine cover and just grab and pull out. It attaches with four rubber bushings to these four posts right here, and make sure that the bushings are not stuck here. If they are, you need to remove them and install them on the cover, so later you can install the cover. Now in order to remove the valve cover, okay, whether you're removing the valve cover or replacing a valve cover gasket, you will need to do quite a bit of work. So first you will need to disconnect the car battery. Why? Because you will be disconnecting the fuel lines and you will be leaking fuel, and if you have sparks, okay, you can catch on fire. On these modern cars, it really matters which battery terminal you disconnect, reconnect first. If you do it the wrong way, you can cause damage to the engine computer. So we have a special video that explains that, and I will put the link in the description of the video below. Number two guys, gotta make sure that your engine is really cool. Let it sit overnight, because if it's hot and you spill fuel, you can catch on fire. Number three, you need to disconnect the low pressure fuel line. Okay, the video is on our channel, how to disconnect fuel line on a Hyundai. Check it out, it's super simple and it will teach you how to do that if you don't know how to. Then what else you need to do? You need to disconnect, okay, the wires, okay, for the pump here, okay, for the high pressure fuel pump. Now on the back side you will have a wire for the, okay, this is for the variable timing solenoid for the exhaust camshaft, okay, and you're going to pull it this way. Right here, this is the PCV valve. Okay, just grab the hose. If you have a clamp, you need to remove the clamp and pull it out. Here you need to remove the safety clip, okay, on the ignition coils, and then if it doesn't want to come out, push in, then press down and disconnect it. You can see just like that, pretty simple. Be careful not to break those, because okay, try to disconnect them with your fingers, because if you break that one, okay, that safety thing, okay, your ignition coils may get loose. Now we're going to disconnect the fuel line right here with a 3/4 inch wrench. You will always have fuel pressure, always use eye protection and gloves guys, so be careful, because most likely you will leak fuel. We may not leak any fuel because we removed the engine, okay, so probably we leaked all the fuel out because we had a few things disconnected before. 10 millimeter socket, and we're going to remove, okay, that wiring harness from the valve cover now. So let's go ahead and do that. Perfect, it's loose. One more there. Okay, great. Now you can see it comes to the side like that. Now we need to remove the fuel pump, high pressure fuel pump. Go a little bit on each side and then remove it all the way. That fuel pump will be under pressure because right here the fuel pump camshaft follower, also known as tappet, could be on a high point in the camshaft. Ours is not. Now, I recommend to inspect your camshaft follower, tappet, and replace it if you need to. We have a special video that explains, okay, the 2.4 GDI engine noise because of a bad fuel pump. So check it out, engine noise 2.4 GDI. Now, we'll remove the ignition coils. And we just noticed now one of them is missing. You're supposed to have a bolt right here. Somebody didn't install it. We'll be rebuilding that engine, and in the meantime we want to teach you how to do things so we can save you as much money as we can guys. Perfect. Now it is right here, so let's see what else we need to do. Okay, we're going to go ahead and remove all the inner bolts of the valve cover here. Now we can go ahead remove these two. Now all the bolts need to come out. Why? Because these bolts will fall, and if you drop one in your engine and you don't know about it, you start your engine later, guys, okay, and it's somewhere in the cylinder head, you're going to damage your camshafts, your engine, and you will need the engine rebuilt or a new engine, guys. So always have to be careful not to drop anything, okay, inside. Okay, I got these two. Okay, right there, both of them, they came out perfect. Now this is the valve cover. Now let's see if we have anything else holding. Always inspect. Okay, we have one hose that is for the air filter, for the intake hose that goes, you can see, towards the air filter holes. Okay, perfect. We disconnect that one and now we should be able to grab that one. The fuel line may be a little bit in the way, so we need to come in an angle and the valve cover comes out just like that. So we can continue with the next step. Now what we will need to do, we actually need to remove the serpentine belt. That will be the next step. We need to get the belt out and we'll need to remove the AC compressor. So in order to do that, here we need to get a 14 millimeter wrench in our case and go counterclockwise. We will release the tensioner pressure and that will make the belt long, and we can simply go ahead and remove it. Just go ahead, grab it and pull it like that. Next, let's explain what we need to do here. Okay, that's the AC compressor. We need to remove it off the engine block, otherwise it will not work out. You don't need to disconnect the lines, okay, and you may be able to do it without draining the Freon, but careful not to break a line because the Freon will leak out. It's illegal. And another thing, it can severely hurt you, your eyes as well, so be careful, guys. So now let's go ahead, okay, do that. So we have four bolts for the AC compressor. Two are on the bottom right here where it attaches to the bracket that is screwed to the oil pan. So we're going to do that, and then we have two more on top, one here, one on the other side, and we need to disconnect the wire as well. That wire is for the AC switch, and this wire is broken. Okay, check it out, we need to fix it. That's why the AC didn't work on this car, so we'll fix it, but you need to disconnect the plug as well, which is pretty simple. So 12 millimeter socket, and we're going to go ahead, okay, and get this loose. It'll be easier if you do the top ones first, guys, because if you do the bottom ones, what can happen, okay, when you do those bottom ones, okay, the top one will not be holding it. So let's go ahead, do the bolts on top. Now one is out. Now if you cannot do it because of the AC lines, you might have to disconnect them or get a wrench, one of the two. So this one, I think the battery is weak on the thing as well, but we can just do it with a wrench, get this one loose. It's not going to work with a ratchet, either a wrench, or we need to remove that low pressure line so we can simply pull it out. So let's go ahead, do that. If we just pre-loosen it, we can simply unscrew the bolt after that. Okay, let me grab it on this side here. It was extremely tight. Okay, that's perfect. Now let's see if it's going to come out. The bolt can stay in the AC at that point. I don't think we'll even need to remove it. Perfect. It can go towards the back. That's great. Now let's do the ones on the bottom. So one bolt will stay in the AC compressor and the rest, okay, will come out. Now that AC compressor will be stuck. You have two guides, one on top, one on the bottom, and they tend to corrode sometimes. So just wiggle it a little bit, be careful, okay, and you can see right here, that's one of the guides. The other one is actually installed on the AC compressor. Okay, and I'm talking, okay, let me see. Right here, okay, so we have two on top, not on the bottom. Now next step, we need to remove that bracket, and for that specific bracket we have 12 millimeter bolts, 2, 3, 4 bolts. Perfect. After that, for the oil pan, we will guys have multiple bolts that we need to remove. With a 10 millimeter socket, we need to go all the way around. Number one thing, okay, before we start, there is another two bolts, long bolts, that are with a 12 point socket, 12 or 14 millimeter 12 point socket. You need to drain your engine oil. Ours is pre-drained, but otherwise you remove the oil pan, you put a bucket or something, drain the engine oil, make sure you don't have oil, okay, in the oil pan. So you can see that silicone just here came loose. We need to find a socket that fits here now. So this is the socket, 12 millimeter. This is a 12 point socket. So let's just simply, those two could be really tight. Why? Because they hold the crankcase to the engine block, the bottom lower part of the crank of the engine block to the upper part of the engine block. So those two will be super tight. Now let's go ahead, start on the 10 millimeter and removing the bolts, okay, for the oil pan. So I'll try my best to show you where exactly they are. So one by one we start removing them. You can see the oil filter housing, okay, is right here. It stays on the engine block. Keep going all the way around. Now that oil pan usually will be glued really bad. Okay, the silicone will make it really tight, so you need to get a screwdriver kind of like and pry it on the farther sections. It's a metal one, so if you bent it, you can straighten it later. But this one hasn't been resealed correctly, so the silicone is leaking everywhere. So we'll be redoing, rebuilding the whole engine. It's barely stuck. Somebody didn't clean it when they re-glue it. What you need to do, okay, when you're doing the oil pan, guys, you need to clean the engine block really good. Get a scraper, clean everything good, clean the oil pan, make sure it's not contaminated. Use the rubbing alcohol to clean the contacting points, like the engine block and the oil pan, and then you apply the silicone. We'll show you which silicone we use in just a second. So let me just grab it quick. So this is, guys, the silicone, okay, right here. Gray gasket maker is a high temperature. This is amazing one. So once you clean everything, you're going to apply it on the inside of the bolt. And what I usually do, I go one small bead around the bolts as well. The bead should be around 3 to 4 millimeters thick, okay, around thick, and then re-glue it together. So you can see oil pan came out. So
So now, when you have in the car, okay, let me explain something. You will need to support your engine, okay, with a tie bar so it doesn't drop, because you need to disconnect, okay, you will need to disconnect your engine mount. Now, on the body, it will be pretty simple. Right here, what you will need to do, okay, you will need to support the engine, make sure it doesn't drop. You have one nut that you need to remove, one nut here, and two nuts here, and one bolt as well. So let's go ahead, do that. If you don't support the engine, everything will drop. You will break your car, your engine. You can break casings, you can break hoses, wiring harness, so always has to be supported. Okay, and you will be able to remove it. You have three more bolts that attach to the body there, and you can remove the whole thing. Now, that's the engine mount bracket here that you will need to proceed with, that bracket. Okay, and the Kia, they like to use 12, 14, and 10 millimeter. So everything now here is with 14 millimeter, except one bolt that somebody lost in the past. I just saw that, and they use a different bolt, which is actually a standard size. It's not metric. Okay, you can see it right there. So that's always a good thing to work on your vehicle, guys. Sometimes you don't know what people do, even though the so-called mechanics will mess things up. Now, right here, you can see you have one guide here for the timing cover that you can spray with penetrating oil if you want, so it can soak. We done that, and one right here, because those will have quite a bit of rust built here. And if you don't spray them, what can happen, actually, that cover can be so stuck that you try to pry it out and you will crack it. We'll talk about that in a second, because if you don't do it right, okay, what can happen, you can damage it and it's expensive. So just a thin spray on those two, okay, so they can actually get that special compound, can work while we're doing everything else. Now, we pre-loosened these three bolts earlier, remember, for the water pump pulley. So once they're pre-loosened, when you have the belt, it's easier to pre-loosen all that stuff, because otherwise in the vehicle you will not be able to use a little impact, so nothing will be holding your pulley, guys. So next, let's go ahead and do, okay, the tensioner pulley right here. The tensioner pulley, in order to remove the belt, you go counterclockwise. So this is a reverse threaded bolt, so we need to go clockwise to remove it. And in our case, it could be quite tight. So we're going to go ahead, actually, and get the wrench. And let's get it loose. Perfect. Now, yep, it goes easy. You can see reverse threaded bolt. Now, right here underneath, we have another bolt, and this is a normal threaded bolt. This is not reverse. This is normal threaded bolt. All we have to do, go ahead, pull that one out as well. Perfect, this one came out. Now you can see even on the engine book, it says Hyundai and Kia right here. The same engine has been used on both, guys. So here, 12 millimeter, 14 millimeter, excuse me. And we need to remove the outboard pulley. Now, we'll need to get the crankshaft pulley out. Let me explain now. You will need to get special tools for that. But for any of you guys, okay, that don't want to use special tools, you can do it, but I do not recommend it. With the special tools, what you can do, remove the engine starter and install the tool on the flywheel, or you can install the tool, okay, through the casing on the transmission right here. You remove these two bolts, practically, you remove these two bolts, you install a special tool that goes in the flywheel here, so it can lock it in place and it's not going anywhere. So now, let me show you, we got our pre-loosen already because we used an impact. Okay, you can do it with an impact, but getting it tight, you cannot get the correct torque specs, and you don't want to leave it loose. Even though this is a keyed pulley, it's not as dangerous as having an engine that doesn't have a keyed pulley. Now, what we can continue with, we can start removing all the bolts for the timing cover. So let's start with 12 millimeters first. Okay, I'll come in an angle like that so you can kind of like see. Okay, where we are now. So, those are the 12s. One more. I think this one we don't need to remove it. This one there, I don't think we will need to. Now we can simply start, okay, by removing all 10 millimeter bolts. Okay, perfect. Now that cover will be usually stuck really bad, as I said, because it will have silicone between the timing cover and the engine block. And if you try to pry it all at once, you can crack it. Watch how thin it is. Listen now. That's super thin, super fragile. We've broken them in the past, so you have to be careful. There is a prying point here, one prying point there, kind of like they go in an angle. You can see, so you go a little bit here, a little bit there, and usually it will be stuck in these guides, but since we actually spread our stew, okay, you can see everything goes pretty easy. Otherwise, it will be really, really stuck, just to warn you about that. So you can see, and that timing cover came out. So this is, guys, the timing cover. Now, when you're ready to put it together, you need to clean everything super good. You can get a scraper and just go clean everything, make sure you don't have any silicone, old silicone like that, okay, needs to come out, okay, it needs to be perfectly clean. It's like brand new, where you have a contact point from the timing cover to the engine block right here. The engine block itself, you need to clean everything really good. You need to clean the cylinder head as well here, and you can see all that silicone everywhere needs to come out. You need to shine it really good. I usually use rubbing alcohol and clean everything really good, so you can remove all that greasiness and engine oil. Clean the timing cover, and we use the gray gasket maker silicone. You're going to apply about 3 millimeter bead, and you need to apply it on the inside of the bolts, okay, inside of the bolts, and sometimes around the bolt I'll put one small bead as well, and later I'll wipe it that way, okay, you can prevent any kind of leaks. But usually you can see you have to go on the inside of the bolts, because the bolts, they don't have an oil contacting point as well. So later you need to reseal your oil pan as well after that. So now for the timing chain, the next procedure, removing the timing chain, there are two things that people usually do, guys. Number one, you can set the engine at TDC point, top dead center. How? You just put the timing cover, okay, you install the crankshaft pulley, and you bring it to TDC, and you need to have actually the camshafts with the dots pointing up, and these two lines right here, okay, parallel to the plane of the cylinder head. The other theory is you bring the engine, all four pistons, to the middle. Okay, that means that all pistons will be to the middle. They'll have about that much space, okay, before they hit the valve, so that way you can avoid, okay, bending a valve if something terribly happens. I recommend to bring the pistons in the middle. That way we can reduce the risk, and we will explain what else you need to do actually to put it together. So I recommend to remove all four spark plugs. In our case, guys, we can practically remove cylinder number 3 and 4, because on that engine 1 and 4 move together, 2 and 3 move together. But I recommend to remove all four of them, okay, and bring them to the point that, okay, I can see that piston is all the way up here now. Bring them to where all four of them are practically lining up. Now, let's remove on cylinder number 3 as well, to have one more, just in case. Okay, I can see, now I got a screwdriver that I can see, don't tap too much, just see where the piston is. And we're going to remove cylinder number 3, we'll put the crankshaft pulley and turn the engine, so all four pistons can be aligned practically. That way we'll not worry about smashing valves, bending valves, okay, which could be costly to repair after that. So now this one, spark plugs loose as well. All we have to do, just grab it, pull it out, perfect. And check out the difference now between cylinder number 4, cylinder number 3 goes all the way in. So what we'll do, okay, we're going to put the crankshaft pulley, turn the engine now. If you have all four spark plugs removed, the engine will turn easily by hand. Okay, what? 1 second. This one came up. This one went down. So go back a little bit. Okay, one second now. Okay, it should have gone. Okay, slow. Let's align them. Okay, like that. Okay, they're about even. I'll recommend to check all four cylinders though. So next step, what we need to do, we need to remove the timing chain tensioner. This is the main timing chain. Every time you replace the timing chain or timing chain components or you remove, you get to that point that you need to remove something, cylinder head, CVVT gear or anything like that, I recommend to replace the whole timing chain kit, including the oil pump, timing chain tensioner, because if it fails, you lose oil pressure and you can say bye-bye to your engine. So, 10mm socket, we're going to remove the timing chain tensioner right now. Perfect, it comes out. Now, next step, we need to remove the timing chain guy, which is one 10mm bolt. Okay, right here you can see, pretty simple. And then we have the timing chain guide on this side with 1, 2, 3 bolts with 10mm. Perfect. Let's do the other one now. You can see we are advancing here, guys. So now that's the chain that's left here, and if you pull that, okay, that crankshaft pulling, it will come out like that, and you can simply remove it, okay, as well. You can grab the chain and pull it out. This is the main chain. Now, how do you remove the oil pump chain? For any of you that don't need that repair, you can ignore it, but I would recommend to do both. Never ever remove that pulley. Why? Because if you do, that oil pump is actually counterbalance shaft as well, and what can happen, okay, it will not be aligned anymore and you will have terrible engine vibrations. So I would recommend, guys, okay, to never ever get that pulley loose. What you need to do in your case, you need to remove the oil pump in order to remove, okay, the timing chain. And how you do that, now we pre-loosen these bolts, but some of them will be extremely heavy, guys, extremely tight. So with 12 millimeter 12 point socket, we're going to remove the bolts. You have 7 bolts for the oil pump right here. You can see 1, then we have number 2. Great, watch how long that bolt is. 3. Number 4. Five. I believe we have 7 bolts. 6. And number 7. Now that oil pump, be careful, it will drop on the last bolt. You need to hold it really good because it can really drop and smash your face practically. Now, we made a mistake, guys. Okay, so let me explain what we were supposed to do first. We were supposed to remove, okay, the timing chain tensioner. The tensioner first. Right here. Tensioner needs to come out first. Okay, that's spring-loaded tensioner. So I'm going to leave it here on the timing chain guide. Now, that pump, let's see if it's going to come out. It will come out like that. To watch out now, right here. Or one of the two, either the bottom or the top. Okay, comes like that. I recommend to remove the timing chain guide for the oil pump as well. So before removing the oil pump, remove the tensioner guide and the other guide. Okay. We were a little bit in a hurry and we didn't do that. So it's fine, but the correct way is to do it the other way. So you can see this is the oil pump timing chain and sprocket here as well for the crankshaft. As you can see, the whole kit came out, oil pump is out as well. So you can see, guys, this is your oil pump. That's the oil pump, but it has the balance shafts, the counterbalance shaft as well. So if you look on this side, okay, you're going to have right here the oil pump screen. That's where the oil pump gets oil from in the oil pan. This is the counterbalance shaft right here, and if I spin it, okay, it's a little bit heavy. Okay, you can see those are two big weights practically right here. Okay, that, okay, that move, so it can balance everything. You can see it just like that. So that's how you guys do it, putting it together practically. It's in reverse order, we took it apart. If you need any questions, please let us know. Hopefully the video will be helpful. Thank you for watching and see you guys next time.